Welcome to the Rich Text Editor tutorial. Here, I will show you how to export Syncfusion Blazor Rich Text Editor content to PDF file. First, let me open an existing Blazor app, where I've added the Syncfusion Blazor Rich Text Editor component with the bind value property bound to the RTE value. Additionally, I have customized the toolbar items on Rich Text Editor. If you want to learn how to get started with the Blazor Rich Text Editor component, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. You can also find this example by following the link provided in the description below. Let's run the example application. As you can see, the Rich Text Editor component is rendered with provided HTML content. Also, you can see the toolbar with defined items. Now, I will show you how to export PDF files in the Blazor Rich Text Editor component. It allows users to convert and save the editor's content as a PDF file, providing a convenient way to preserve and share formatted text, images, and other elements in a portable document format. To do this, I'll create a custom toolbar item for an export button. I already installed the Syncfusion Blazor Buttons NuGet package. So, I include the Syncfusion Blazor Buttons namespace. Next, I'll define the Rich Text Editor Custom Toolbar Item tag inside the Rich Text Editor Custom Toolbar Items tag, with the name property set to Export PDF. Afterward, I update the toolbar item inside the tools list to display the export icon. Within the Custom Toolbar Item tag, I'll set up the template section containing Syncfusion Blazor button component. This button will trigger the export action when clicked. Here, I first configure the CSS class and icon class properties within the Syncfusion Blazor button component to show the button component in the toolbar. I apply CSS rules to customize the appearance of various elements associated with the export functionality. Look now, you can see the Export PDF button in the toolbar item. Next, I am going to show how to add logic to export the Rich Text Editor content while clicking this button. First, I configure its on-click event within the Syncfusion Blazor button component. In this event, I will bind the event handler which is responsible for handling the export PDF file. To do this, I create the private async method named clickHandler. This event handler will manage the export functionality within the Syncfusion Blazor Rich Text Editor component. Before proceeding, I bind the clickHandler method to onClickEvent. Then, I define a string variable called RichTextEditorStyle. This variable encapsulates CSS styling rules that dictate the visual presentation of content within the Rich Text Editor. These CSS rules allow customization of the appearance of various HTML elements such as paragraphs, headings, images, tables, and more. Inside the clickHandler method, I generate an HTML string named frameValue by combining a division element with a specific class and style, containing CSS rules defined in the Rich Text Editor style variable. The content of the Rich Text Editor, RTE value, is inserted within this division element. Next, I will create the Export to PDF method for invoking within the Download File method. I already installed Syncfusion PDF NuGet package. So I include the Syncfusion PDF namespace, which enables the creation and manipulation of PDF documents. Additionally, I include the Syncfusion HTML converter namespace, allowing seamless conversion of HTML content to the PDF format. Next, I create a public method named exportsPDF of type memoryStream, which accepts a string parameter called content containing the generated PDF document. Within this method, I initialize an instance of the HTML to PDF converter class, utilized for converting HTML content to a PDF document. Subsequently, I create an instance of the Blink Converter Settings class to hold settings for the HTML to PDF conversion process. I set the viewport size for the conversion process, specifying the width as 1280 pixels, and leaving the height as 0, implying automatic adjustment. The Blink Converter settings are assigned to the Converter Settings property using an HTML converter instance, enabling the converter to utilize these settings for the conversion. The conversion process is initiated by calling the convert method using HTML to PDF converter, taking the content as input and an empty string as the base URL for any additional resources referenced in the HTML. Following that, I create a new memory stream object, which will store the PDF content generated by the conversion process. The resulting PDF document is saved into this memory stream. Finally, I return the memory stream containing the PDF document. Inside the clickhandler method, I invoke the exportSPDF method, passing the composed HTML string frame value as a parameter. This method triggers the conversion process, transforming the HTML content into a PDF document and returning a memory stream containing the PDF data. Moving on, I navigate to the host CSHTML file. I have already created the JavaScript function that can be used to save a file with a given file name and base64 encoded content. If you want to know more information about Save the PDF file, check out the Import and Export HTML file video link provided in the description below. Next, in the index file, I create a public async method named SaveAs, which takes three parameters: JavaScript interop, file name, and binary data. Within this method, I utilize the created JavaScript function saveAsFile using the invoke async method. It's important to note that this JavaScript function is expected to exist on the client side. I pass two arguments to this function, the file name and the binary data converted into a base64 encoded string. Next, I declare the property named JSRuntime of type iJSRuntime. It is interface in Blazor used for interacting with JavaScript code from .NET code. Inside the clickhandler method, I execute the saveAs method, which typically prompts a download or saves the PDF file on the client side. Look now, the rich text editor rendered with export PDF button. Now I add various types of content such as hyperlinks, table, ordered list, and image. Upon clicking the Export PDF button, notice the PDF file is promptly downloaded with the provided name. Upon opening the PDF file, observe that the content is displayed in the same manner as it appears in the rich text editor. Now let me summarize the key takeaways from this video. I covered how to export rich text editor content to PDF file. For more information on the RTE's features, check out the documentation link provided in this video's description. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.